So you're bad at building a redstone? Well, today I'm going to show you how to install and use Litematica. Have fun. Keep in mind that this mod might be forbidden on some servers. If you want to use it on our SMP, the Hoon SMP, go ahead, it's allowed. I like to get straight to the point, so let's just start with the tutorial. There are four links in the description that you will need. Before doing anything, close Minecraft. Step 1. Installing Fabric. Click the first link, which will lead you to fabricmc.net. Click on the download button here, where you can decide whether you want to get the Windows or Universal version. I'm going to get the Windows one, open it up, decide which version you want, for me it's 1.18.1, and click on install. Step 2. Installing the mods. Click the other three links. You will be on the download page of Litematica, MeleeLib, which is a dependency, and Fabric API, which you need to run most Fabric mods. Choose the correct version for each, for me it's all 1.18.1. Once it's all downloaded, you have to open your file explorer and type %appdata% into the search bar. You can also do this with Windows plus R. Navigate to your .minecraft folder and go into the mods folder. If you don't have one already, just create a folder and call it mods, not capitalized. Drag and drop the three mods into that folder and you're good to go. Step 3. Running Minecraft. Open your launcher and it should automatically show you the Fabric profile. If it doesn't, check your other profiles or create a new one. You can now start the version. Now I'm going to show you how to use the mod. This again is divided into three parts. Part 1. Selecting and saving schematics. Go to the building that you want to copy. Press M and C to open up the Litematica config. Here you can customize many things, which isn't important, but I just wanted to show you. To select the schematica, press M and go to the area editor. There is a simple and a normal mode. The normal mode is a bit bugged for me, so I'm going to show you how to use the simple mode. Basically, you have to cover your building with two points. Click on Move to Player to move the first corner to you. Then go onto the other side of the building and set corner 2. Everything in the middle is now selected. You can also fine-tune your selection by scrolling right here. When that is done, give your selection a name and click on Save Schematic. And click on it again. Your schematic is now in the .minecraft folder under Schematics. Part 2. Downloading and importing schematics. I currently know about 4 really good sites where you can get your schematic cast from. They will be all linked in the description. The first one is appfielder.com. This one is more about redstone constructions and farms. They upload farms made by Ilmango, Waddles and others. I'll just try to get this wheat farm right here. It comes in a zip file with a world and a Litematica file. The second one is planetminecraft.com with a specific search filter, so click on the link. This is a community made one, so you never know if it gives you the world download or a Litematica file. The third site is minecraftschematics.com, where you can get great map downloads and schematica files. Not Litematica files though. Schematica files are made for an older version and are incompatible. So here you would have to import the map and make the Litematica file yourself. And the fourth site is YouTube. Just search for literally any building tutorials and you'll most likely find a map download in the description. I can recommend DiddyHD for example. If you downloaded a .litematica file, just drag and drop it into your schematics folder like so. If you downloaded a world file, you need to unzip it and put it into your saves folder. Open the map and make the schematic yourself. Part 3. Building. So you have your Litematica in the folder, then now it's building time. Go back in-game and press M. Click on Load Schematic, select the one you want and load it. Now we can already see how it's gonna look like, but let's move it around first. Go to Schematic Placements, Configure, and here you can move it around, rotate and all that fun stuff. Also, here's a list of materials that you will need to build it in survival. Right here you can also activate an info HUD. What I like to do is press M and C, go to layers and only activate certain layers, like this. And now you can just start building. It will also tell you if you built something wrong or unnecessary. And those are all the features I use. There are surely more that you can look up on their wiki, which is also linked in the description. If you want to join my SMP, check out this video on the end screen, or if you want to see how I build a Japanese temple with Litematica, click on the video on the right. Have a nice day, and I'll see you soon. Bye bye.